welcome to Bloomberg Quinn. Dixon Technologies reported strong quarter with revenues growing as much as 44% compared to last year. To give us more detail on what aided the growth in the quarter gone by and what's the outlook going ahead, joining us now on the show is Saurabh Gupta, the CFO of the company. Hi, Saurabh. Good morning to you and thanks a lot for joining us on Bloomberg Quinn. Well, there are a lot of companies which reported numbers and they said there was slowdown witnessed in the March quarter, be it because of liquidity crunch or because of elections, but you posted a good top line of almost 44%. Tell us what aided this growth on the top line, and also if you could just give us a sense in terms of volume growth across your segments like washing machine, TV and refrigerators.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning, everybody. I think you're absolutely right. I think so post Diwali, there has been a slowdown in the economy, especially on the auto side and the consumer durable industry. And partly that is attributable to the whole NBFC crisis that has happened. There's a liquidity issue in the economy right now. I think so we have been fortunate that we have been continuously able to add customers across all the verticals, and especially across the lighting segment, the washing machine segment, and the consumer electronics segment, and which is kind of reflected in our results. So the volume growth has been strong. So in consumer electronic, we have added Xiaomi as a customer, and we have a strong order book with Xiaomi going forward as well. And we are also talking to some other brands as well, which can, of course, take care of the increased capacity that we have built up at our Tirupati plant down South India. If you look at the washing machine segment, again, one of our major anchor customers, which is Samsung, has year-on-year just increasing their commitment to us. We see that most of their quantities year-on-year will keep getting outsourced to us in the semi-automatic category. We are also now getting into the fully automatic top-load version in 6 and 7 kV category, and which would commence production by Q4 of the current financial year. As far as the lighting segment is concerned, we today account for almost 50% of the lighting business of the organized market in India, and we have all the big customers like Philips, Panasonic, Anker, Bajaj, Wipro, Orient, Jaguar, Cisco, Polycap. So things are looking really great. We are now also, apart from the LED bulbs, we are expanding the capacity from 18 million per month to 20 million per month. And we are now expanding the capacity in battens, which is another form of indoor lighting. So 2019-20 will be a year where we will be expanding our capacity in battens, deepening our relationship further with the customers. There will be more backward integration. And we think now we are among the top 5 companies in the world as far as capacities are concerned. So we will make a big attempt for the global business as well.
Saurabh, so going ahead into FY20, do you think lighting, that's the segment which will continue to outperform and contribute the most to your earnings?
Lighting will continue to do, and not only in terms of revenues, but in terms of the margins as well. Because as we continuously keep adding more customers, that has a multiple operating leverage in our business. Secondly, the increased percentage of my own design in the overall segment has also led to the margin expansion. So that will continue to grow. And I think so we are looking for a big export play as far as lighting is concerned, so that can really grow my business multifold. But if you look at the other two segments as well, which is consumer electronic and the washing machine segment, I think so we have a very big strong order book in both the other segments as well. And we think we can continue to grow by 25-30% in those segments as well.
But if one were to look at the year in totality, the reverse logistics and mobile segments, they continue to be the pain point for the company. How are you planning to address these two segments going into FY20?
Yes, so mobile, I think it should come back on track sooner because, as you mentioned, we are in a very advanced discussions with a very big account in mobile phone, which has a deeper market share in India. And we should be able to start business with them in a very short period of time. We have already taken an additional space in Noida for that. So mobile in a couple of quarters should come back on track. That would the new customer would improve my capacity utilization and will lead to increased revenues and profitability. Yeah, reverse logistics has been a challenge, and I think so it will continue to be a challenge for some more time. There were three parts of reverse logistics, which are set-top box business, mobile phone repair business, and LED TV panel repair business. So LED TV panel continues to grow. Mobile is also seeing some kind of traction. But the set-top box business is completely facing serious challenges. And we are in the process of reducing both the manpower and the overheads in, as far as that business is concerned. So we are reducing the investments, and the idea and the focus is to focus on the LED TV panel and the mobile repair business.
Saurabh, you're sounding pretty bullish going into FY20. Give us a guidance then, because if I look at FY19, your top line's grown by 5%, then there is some bit of margin expansion of about 60 bips. What sort of margins can investors now watch out going into FY20, and what sort of growth can one expect on the top line?
Yeah, so we are absolutely confident. I think so we'll continue to grow by 25-30% given the order book that we have. And the margin expansion should also happen primarily as we keep migrating more and more to our own design, as we focus on backward integration, achieve a scale and size. So all these factors help in margin expansion. So I think so margin expansion should continue to happen by 40 to 50 bips year on year, at least for some years. And the revenue growth is looking like a 25 to 30% growth is what I can project for next year.
Okay, and one last question from my side. Your bottom line has been impacted because of higher finance costs, and I was just looking at your balance sheet. Your gross debt has gone up to 141 crore, and largely it's because of your short-term borrowings are going up. It's about 130 versus 32, which was seen in the last year. Will this scenario continue? Will you still require more debt going ahead into FY20 for your working capital, or are you planning to scale down your finance cost, which has been really high in FY19?
So as of now, as of things stand today, I think so the working capital intensity has increased in lighting, and because that is, we have migrated more and more to the own design business. Our washing machine was always 100% own design business, so that entails again the working capital. Now we have also got some working capital in the TV business as well. So as of now, I don't see the interest cost coming down, but what I can mention that with the order book that we have, the revenues will grow. So at a PBT level, which factors in the interest cost, I think so we'll still grow at 25-30% level.
Okay, Saurabh, we'll leave it at that note. Thanks a lot for joining us and taking us through the quarter gone by. All the best to you for FY20.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, we'll slip into a short break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back with more news and updates on the other side.